numbers from 0 to 100.
Hey, hello kids. I am Parrot and I welcome you to this lesson. So let's see what will you learn in this lesson today. Reading the numbers in ones and tens. And determining the number by counting ones and tens. So today Chotu and Pinky have come to the market to buy a toy.
Pinky, look at this. This is such a nice toy. We should buy it.
Yes, Chotu, you are right. The price written here is rupees 38.
38 rupees means we have to give 3 notes of rupees 10 and also 8 coins of rupee 1.
But why is that, Chotu?
Look, Pinky, in 38, 3 is in the tens place and 8 is in the ones place. 3 tens means 3 counts of 10 or 3 notes of 10 rupees. And 8 ones means 8 coins of 1 rupee.
So we have to give 3 notes of 10 rupees and 8 coins of 1 rupee. Isn't it right?
Yes, Pinky. Come, let us buy it now.
Chotu gave 38 rupees to the shopkeeper and took the toy from him. So today Chotu and Pinky have come to the museum with their mother. They are seeing many interesting and antique items here. So come, let's see what all 3 of them are seeing.
Oh wow, there are so many utensils here. Mom, why don't we use such utensils at our home?
Chotu, these utensils are really old and they were used a long time ago.
Chotu, come, let's see how many utensils are these.
Yes, Pinky, let us count these.
Chotu, here 10 utensils are kept together, so it will be easy for us to count.
Yes, you are right, Pinky.
These are 10, 20, 30 and 40. These are 40 utensils.
Pinky, see, 5 more utensils are kept here.
Hi again, kids. So do you know how many utensils did Chotu and Pinky see in the museum?
After 40 utensils, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. This makes total 45 utensils.
Hey kids, did you see how Chotu and Pinky counted these utensils? There were 4 sets of utensils containing 10 each, which means 4 tens. So in the tens place would be 4. And 5 more utensils, that is 5 ones. It means 5 would come in ones place. So children, Chotu and Pinky saw 45 utensils in total. So children, that's all for today. And in this video, we learned to read numbers in tens and ones and counting numbers by tens and ones. In the next video, we will learn to count numbers forward and backwards. Till then, bye-bye, kids!
Numbers from 51 to 60.
Our friends, I am the Parrot. You are welcome to this lesson. Come, let us see what you will learn in this lesson. Numbers from 51 to 60 and writing those numbers in terms of ones and tens. Today, Chotu's mother has given him many almonds.
Chotu, I need your help. Make pouches of these almonds. Then it will be easy to distribute them.
Alright, Mummy. I can make pouches with 10 almonds in each pouch. Then I'll be able to count the almonds easily. See this, Mummy? I have made so many pouches.
Chotu, how many pouches of almonds have you made?
Children, can you tell me how many pouches of almonds has Chotu made? Come, let us see.
Mummy, I have made 5 pouches with 10 almonds in each. So it comes to 50 almonds.
Okay, now Chotu, take 5 more almonds. Count these as well.
So earlier I had 50 almonds and 5 more almonds. So it will make 51, 52, 53, 54 and 55. It means 55 almonds.
Yes, Chotu. So can you tell me how many 1s and 10s are there in 55?
Yes, Mummy. 55 has 5 10s and 5 1s.
Very good. Chotu, you are absolutely correct.
Chotu's mother has given him some more almonds. Let us see what he is doing now.
Mummy, these are 5 more almonds.
Yes, Chotu. Can you now count and tell me how many almonds you have in total?
To begin with, I had 55 almonds, which means 5 10s and 5 1s, and now 5 more 1s. So, after 55 comes 56, 57, 58, 59 and 60. This means 60 almonds.
So Chotu, how many 1s and 10s do you have right now?
Mummy, now I have 5 10s and 10 1s.
So children, what do you think? Has Chotu answered correctly? Let us see.
Yes Chotu, you are right. 5 10s means 50 almonds. And 10 ones means 10 almonds. And these 10 almonds will make 1 more 10s. So in all we have 6 10s, meaning 60 almonds.
60 almonds means 6 groups of 10 almonds each, which becomes 6 10s. Is this right, Mummy?
Yes, Chotu, you are right.
So children, that is all for today. In this video, we have learned about numbers from 51 to 60 and how to read these numbers in terms of 1s and 10s. In the next video, we will learn about numbers from 61 to 70. Until then, bye children.
Numbers from 61 to 70.
Hello children. In the previous video, we had learned how to read numbers from 51 to 60 in terms of 1s and 10s. In this video, we will learn numbers from 61 to 70 and some interesting examples on how to read those numbers in terms of 1s and 10s. Children, today Chotu with his friends is going on a school tour to a candle making factory where beautiful candles are being made and then sent to shops where these are sold.
Oh Pinky, look, this place has so many candles.
Yes, but how do these people count so many candles?
Come, let me tell you. They first put 10 candles in each box. Right now, we have 6 such boxes in front of us.
So, can you tell me how many candles must be there in total?
Yes, see, there are 6 boxes with 10 candles in each of them. 6 boxes would mean 60 candles.
Chotu, look, there are 4 more candles. Please count these as well.
We have 6 boxes of candles here, which means 60 candles. And 4 more along with these comes to 61, 62, 63 and 64. These are 64 in total. Pinky, can you tell me how many 1s and 10s are there in 64?
Yes, 64 has 6 10s and 4 1s.
Excellent, you are absolutely correct.
A little later, Chotu and Pinky found some more candles there.
Come, let us see what they are doing now.
Oh, look, Pinky. Some more candles.
Yes, Chotu. Let us count these also. Earlier, we had a total of 64 candles. And now, we have 5 more.
Children, do you know how many candles have Chotu and Pinky seen so far? Come, let us find.
After 64 candles, it will be 65, 66, 67, 68, 69.
So these are now 69 candles. Chotu, can you tell me how many tens and ones are there in 69?
69 has 6 tens and 9 ones.
Yes, Chotu, you are right. Earlier we saw 6 groups of 10 candles each, and then we saw 9 loose candles, which means 9 ones.
Yes, Pinky, counting candles was a lot of fun today.
Children, you saw how Chotu and Pinky counted candles. They had 69 candles, which means 6 tens and 9 ones. Children, had Chotu and Pinky got one more candle, then what would have become the total number of candles? They would have got 70 candles. Meaning, after 6 groups of 10 candles, they would have got one more bundle of 10 candles. This means 7 tens. That was all for today, children. In this video, we have learned about numbers from 61 to 70 and saw some interesting examples about how to read those numbers in terms of ones and tens. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples related to numbers from 51 to 70 and discuss some common mistakes that we should avoid. Until then, bye children.
Interesting examples of numbers from 51 to 70.
Hello children. In the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of numbers from 51 to 70. In this video, we will see some more examples related to those numbers. We will also discuss about the common mistakes that we should avoid. Today, Chotu and Aarti are playing a game together. At the end of the game, they are figuring out who got a higher score.
I have scored 56. Aarti, what is your score?
Chotu, I have scored 65 points.
Hey, this means that our scores are the same. Aarti, both of us have won this game.
No, Chotu, I have scored more than you.
Let us go to Mummy and ask her that who has scored more.
Alright, Chotu, let us go.
Children, what do you think? Are 56 and 65 equal? Come, let us see. 56 means 5 tens and 6 ones. And 65 means 6 tens and 5 ones. The two numbers have different tens and ones. This means that 56 and 65 are not equal. Children, can you tell me which number is greater between the two? Yes, correct. 65 is the greater number because it has more tens.
Now do you understand, Chotu? Since 65 is a greater number, I have won the game.
Yes, I have understood, Aarti.
Anyway, Chotu, now I am going home. See you tomorrow.
Chotu and Aarti are thinking of making a model today with matchsticks.
Aarti, we will need 70 matchsticks for the model.
Alright, Chotu. Let us ask Mummy for matchsticks.
Mummy, please give us matchsticks. We want to make a model using them.
Okay, take these.
Oh, Chotu, these are too many matchsticks. Let us take 70 out of this pile. Please make bundles of 10 each of these so that counting becomes easier.
Alright, I will count. So these are now 70 matchsticks.
Oh, Chotu, how many bundles have you made?
Aarti, for 70 we needed 7 bundles and 70 has a 0 also, which means 10 more matchsticks. Therefore, I have made 8 bundles of 10 matchsticks.
You are not doing this correctly, Chotu. Wait, let me explain. 70 has 7 tens and 0 ones.
0 ones? What does 0 ones mean?
0 ones means there is not even a single loose matchstick. For 70 matchsticks, you will need to make 7 bundles of 10 matchsticks each.
Okay, now I have understood. Thank you, Aarti.
So children, that is all for today. In this video, we saw some common mistakes that we should avoid. For instance, 56 and 65 are not equal. And if a number has 0 in one's place, it does not mean 10. I sincerely hope that you have understood this topic. Bye, friends.
Numbers from 71 to 80.
Hello friends, I am a parrot. You are welcome to this video. Let us see what you will learn in this lesson. Numbers from 71 to 80 and reading those numbers in terms of ones and tens. Chotu and Pinky have gone to the market today to buy several bamboo sticks. They will build a small house with those sticks. Pinky, how many sticks should we buy?
Chotu, I think 2 packets should be enough.
All right, Pinky. Auntie, please give us 2 packets of sticks. Chotu and Pinky return home with 2 packets of sticks. Let us see what they are doing now.
Okay, Chotu, let us first count these sticks. And for that, let us make bundles with 10 sticks in each.
Alright, Pinky. So, we have 7 bundles of 10 sticks each. So, children, can you tell how many sticks have Chotu and Pinky got in total?
7 bundles of 10 sticks each. This means we have 7 tens.
Yes, Pinky. And 7 tens are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and 70. So we have 70 sticks.
Alright, Chotu, now let us build the house.
Chotu and Pinky could not complete the house with 70 sticks. Let us see what they are doing now.
Oh no, we do not have enough sticks to make the door of the house.
Chotu, I will get more sticks from Auntie.
Pinky, we need 10 more sticks. Pinky gets 10 more sticks. And then Chotu and Pinky finish making the house.
Our house is complete now. Pinky, let us show it to Sonu and Neha.
Children, did you see what a beautiful house Chotu and Pinky have built? Do you know how many sticks they used to build the house? Come, let us see. Initially, they had 70 sticks. And then Pinky got 10 more sticks. So the number became 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80. So the total numbers of sticks is 80. So with these 10 more sticks, one more bundle of 10 can be made. It means one more tens. So children, can you tell how many tens and ones are there in 80? Yes, children, 80 has 8 bundles of 10 sticks each and no loose stick. This means 80 has 8 tens and 0 ones. So children, that is all for today. In this video, you learned how to read numbers from 71 to 80 in terms of ones and tens. In the next video, we will learn about numbers from 81 to 90. Until then, bye children.
Numbers from 81 to 90.
Hello children, In the last video, you learnt about numbers from 71 to 80 and reading them in terms of ones and tens. In this video, we will learn about numbers from 81 to 90. Today, Pinky and Chotu will make white flower garlands for their mother.
Pinky, how many flowers we will need for the garlands?
I don't know, Chotu. Let's ask Mother.
Mother, we need to make many garlands. How many flowers would we need?
Chotu, Pinky, you could use 10 flowers for one garland. Take as many flowers as you need for the number of garlands.
Alright, Mother. Pinky, let us go to the market and buy some flowers.
Chotu and Pinky have brought many flowers from the market.
Chotu, come, let us make garlands with these flowers.
Pinky, look, I have made a garland with 10 flowers.
Wow, Chotu, now let us make more garlands.
Chotu, can you tell so far how many flowers we have used in making the garlands?
See, we have made 8 garlands of 10 flowers each. So it comes to 80 flowers.
Oh, Chotu, look, there are 5 more flowers here.
Let us count these as well.
Alright, so we had 80 flowers and 5 more would mean 81, 82, 83, 84 and 85. The total is 85 flowers.
Chotu, can you tell how many ones and tens there are in 85?
Yes, 85 has 8 tens and 5 ones.
You are right, Chotu. Let us make a garland out of these.
While Chotu and Pinky were making the garland, their mother came to them.
Chotu, Pinky, look, I found these flowers lying close to the door. You must have dropped these while coming in. Here, use these as well.
Oh, wow, more flowers. Perhaps we can make one more garland now.
Chotu, we had 85 flowers and now Mother has given us 5 more.
So, how many flowers do we have in total now?
Children, do you know how many flowers Chotu and Pinky now have? Come, let us see.
Look, Pinky, earlier we had 85 flowers and then we got 5 more. That makes it 86, 87, 88, 89 and 90. We have 90 flowers in total.
Chotu, do you know how many ones and tens does the number 90 have?
Yes, Pinky, 90 has 9 tens and 0 ones.
Children, that is all for today. In this video, we learnt about numbers from 81 to 90. In the next video, we will watch some interesting examples related to numbers from 71 to 90. And we will also learn about some common mistakes that we should avoid. Until then, bye children.
Interesting examples and common mistakes related to numbers from 71 to 90.
Hello children, in the last video we saw some interesting examples of numbers from 71 to 90. In this video we will watch some more interesting examples related to those numbers. Additionally, we will learn about some common mistakes that we should avoid. Chotu's mother is sending him today to get walnuts.
Chotu, please get 85 walnuts from the market.
Alright, Mother. Chotu has brought walnuts from the market. Let us see how many walnuts he has got.
Here, Mother, I have got 85 walnuts.
Chotu, they seem lesser than 85. Can you count and tell me how many these are?
Sure, Mother. I will just count these. So first of all, here are 5 pouches of 10 walnuts each, which means 10,
20, 30, 40 and 50 with 8 more red becomes 85.
Oh Chotu, you have brought lesser number of walnuts. I had asked for 85 and these are only 58 because you took 5 pouches of 10 walnuts each and 8 loose nuts. Come tell me, how many 10s and 1s does 85 have?
85 has 8 1s and 5 10s.
Oh no Chotu, this is incorrect. 85 has 5 1s and 8 10s. 85 and 58 are not equal.
Oh yes mother, now I have understood. I will go and get more walnuts. In this example, we saw that in a number, this place tells us about 1s and this place about 10s. If the digit of these places get exchanged, then the value of the number changes. Understood, children? Let us see one more example. Today, Chotu and Pinky are playing with their toys.
Pinky, it's written on top of this box that this box has 8 toys in it. But it seems there are more than 8 toys.
Yes, Chotu, you are right. This box has more than 8 toys. Because what you are reading is not 8 but 80.
Pinky, but here it says 8 and next to it is a 0. And 0 means nothing at all. So it means 8.
No Chotu, here 8 is at the tens place. And this means 8 groups of 10 toys each. So it comes to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 and 80 toys. And 0 is at 1's place, which means not even a single loose toy. Oh, so it means that this 0 is telling us only about the 1's place. Yes, Chotu, 80 has 0 1's and 8 10's. And 8 has 8 in the 1's place and 0 being in the 10's place. So see, there is a lot of difference between the two numbers. 80 is bigger than 8. Alright Pinky, I have understood. Let us start playing now.
So children, that is all for today. In these videos, we learnt about numbers from 71 to 90. I hope you have fully understood this topic. Bye friends.
Introduction to numbers from 91 to 99.
Hello friends, I'm the parrot. Welcome to this lesson. Come, let us see what we will learn in this lesson. Numbers from 91 to 99 and reading those numbers as ones and tens. Today all the children in the school have brought their old books. These books will be given to those children who cannot afford to buy these books. Chotu and Aarti have got the work of counting all the books in their class.
Aarti, there are so many books kept here. How shall we count them?
Look Chotu, we can do one thing. We can make sets of 10 books each. This will make it very easy to count.
Alright.
Chotu and Aarti started making sets of 10 each.
Chotu, how many sets of books have been made?
Aarti, 9 sets of 10 books have been made.
Okay, 9 sets of 10, which means 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90. This means 90 books.
Yes, 90 books.
Children, can you tell me how many 1s and how many 10s are there in 90? Come on, let us see. Children, This is how we write 90. Here 9 is at the tens place and 0 in the ones place. This means we have 9 tens, which we can also call 9 bundles of 10, which is 90, and there is no ones here. So did you see, children? 9 tens means 90 books. This shows that Chotu and Aarti have counted 90 books so far. After some time, Neha gave 5 more books to Chotu and Aarti. So children, can you tell me how many books they have with them now? Come on, let us see. Initially, they had 90 books. And later, they got 5 more books. So which makes it 91, 92, 93, 94, 95. So this means they have 95 books in total. Can you tell me how many ones and how many tens are there in 95? Children, this is how we write 95. Here 9 is at the tens place and 5 is at the ones place. This means we have 9 tens, which we can also call 9 bundles of 10, which is 90. And along with that, 5 ones, which means 5 books. After a while, Sonu brought some more books. So let us see how many books Chotu and Pinky together have right now.
Chotu, initially there were 95 books, and then 96, 97, 98, 99.
Children, this means they have 99 books altogether. We write 99 like this. And here 9 is at tens place and 9 is at ones place. So that means we have 9 tens, which we can also call 9 bundles of 10, and along with that 9 ones. So children, that was all for today. In this video, we learned to read numbers from 91 to 99 and to read those numbers in the form of ones and tens. In the next video, we will learn about 100 and learn to read 100 as ones and tens. Till then, bye children.
Introduction to 100.
Hello children. In the last video, you learned numbers from 91 to 99 and also read those numbers as ones and tens. So come on, let's see what you will learn in this video about 100 and how many ones and tens are there in 100. Today is Chotu and Pinky's mother's birthday. Chotu and Pinky put 1 coin each in their piggy bank every day. So they thought of taking money from the piggy bank and buy a gift for their mother.
Chotu, let's check in our piggy bank how many rupees are there, and then we will bring something for mummy from the market.
Okay, Pinky, let's see.
Chotu, let's count all these coins by making groups of 10 each.
So these are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90.
And along with that, there are 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, and 99. This means we have 99 rupees in total.
So children, did you see how Chotu and Pinky counted the money of their piggy bank?
Can you tell me how many ones and how many tens are there in 99?
Yes, children. We write 99 like this.
Here 9 is in the tens place and this 9 is in the nines place. That means we have 9 tens, which can be also called as 9 bundles of tens and 9 ones.
After some time, Chotu and Pinky notice that there is another rupee in their piggy bank. So this means now they have 1 rupee more than 99 rupees.
So children, do you know what is 1 more than 99? And how shall we count it?
Yes, 100 is more than 99.
Come on, let us see how.
There are 9 ones and 9 tens. And if there is one more one in it, then it will become 10 coins, which means 10 ones. And together, 10 ones will make 110, which means one more group of 10. That means earlier we had 9 tens and now 110 more. And now we have 10 tens, which we call as 100. So 100 comes after 99, which we write like this.
So children, that was all for today. In this video, you learned about 100 and learned to read 100 as ones and tens. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of numbers from 91 to 100. Till then, bye children.
Interesting examples of numbers from 91 to 100.
Hello children, in the previous video you learned numbers from 91 to 100 and read those numbers as ones and tens. In this video we will see some more interesting examples of those numbers. Nowadays there is a fair near Chotu's house. Chotu and Pinky have also gone to the fair. They liked a game at the fair. In this game, they are given lots of pencils and they have to count them as quickly as possible. The one who tells quickly gets the reward.
Chotu, first I will do it. Uncle, please give me the pencils.
Uncle has given some pencils to Pinky. Let's see how she is counting them.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
No, wait, Pinky. This will take you a long time to count. It is better if you count them as groups of 10.
Okay, Chotu. So these are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90. This means there are 90 pencils and plus 6 pencils more. So first of all, there are 90 pencils and 6 more pencils with me. So 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, and 96. So there are 96 pencils.
Children, Pinky said it right and got the prize also. Now can you tell how many ones and tens are there in 96? Come on, let's see. Children, we write 96 like this. And in this, 9 is in the tens place and 6 in ones place. It means we have 9 tens, which we can also call 9 bundles of 10, and along with it, 6 ones means 6 loose pencils.
Choto has gone to the store with his mother to buy the goods.
Mummy, why are these pencils placed here in two different places?
Choto, look. Here the pencils are kept in groups of 10. And there are loose pencils here.
Okay, but why is this, Mummy?
Wait, Choto, I'll tell you. First of all, do one thing. Give me 95 pencils out of these.
Now I understood, Mummy. That means I will give 9 bundles of 10 pencils and 5 loose pencils. So to give 95 pencils, I have to give 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 5 loose pencils. So that is 91, 92, 93, 94, 95.
Yes, Chotu. You are absolutely right. But if there were only loose pencils, then it would have taken a long time. That's why here the pencils are also kept in bundle of 10.
So children, you saw how Chotu used bundles and loose pencils to give 95 pencils. He gave 9 bundles of 10 pencils to his mother, which means 9 tens, and together 5 loose pencils, which means 5 ones. So children, that was all for today. In this video, we saw some interesting examples of numbers from 91 to 100. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples of numbers from 91 to 100 and learn about some common mistakes that we all should avoid. Till then, bye children!
Related to numbers from 91 to 100.
Hello kids! In the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of numbers from 91 to 100. In this video, we will see some interesting examples related to numbers from 91 to 100 and learn about some common mistakes which should not be made. Today, Chotu and Pinky's teacher has asked them to make a chart of numbers from 91 to 100.
Pinky, let's write the ones and tens of these numbers in the chart.
Okay, Chotu.
Pinky and Chotu have written numbers from 91 to 100. And also write the ones and tens of some numbers. Both of them are going to show the chart to their mother before writing further.
Mummy, look, we are preparing this chart to put in class.
Hey children, you have written it upside down. We write 91 like this, and there are 9 tens and 1 ones in it. That means 9 bundles of 10 and 1 loose.
Oh yes. We have made this mistake in all the numbers.
Take this and just fix it up.
Okay, Mummy.
Chotu and Pinky then corrected their charts. Come on, let's see what they wrote now. It is written here that there are 9 tens and 1 ones in 91. Then there are 9 tens and 2 ones in 92. And just like that, they corrected all the numbers and wrote them down. Chotu's birthday is coming up. And every year, Chotu gives some gifts to all his friends.
Hey Chotu, what will you give to your friends this time?
Mummy, this time I will give them small little packets of toffees.
Oh wow, this would be a very cute gift.
Yes, Mummy.
Well, tell me, Chotu, that how many toffees you have brought for your friends?
Mummy, let me count them.
Chotu started counting the packets.
This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there are 10 total packets. And 10 packets will make 100 toffees. Isn't it, Mummy?
Chotu, but why do some bags look small and some seems big?
Yes, Mummy. There are less toffees in some packets.
No, Chotu. Here we count a packet as 10 because there are 10 toffees in all the packets. If there are not 10 toffees in all, then we have to open all the packets and count them one by one.
But it will take a lot of time, Mummy.
Yes, Chotu. So we should put 10 toffees in each packet before we start counting the packets.
Okay, Mummy, I understood.
Children, did you see what mistake Chotu made? Even y'all should not make such mistake. We should keep this in mind while making groups of 10 and counting that each group is made up of 10 things. Groups made up of different number of things are not counted as 10s. So children, that was all for today. In these videos, we learned about numbers from 91 to 100. I hope you have understood this topic properly. Bye, friends.
Counting numbers forward and backwards.
Hello kids! In the previous video, you learned to read numbers in ones and tens. Also, counting numbers by ones and tens. So let's see what you will learn in this lesson. So in today's video, we will learn what is moving forward and what is going backwards. Along with this, we will also learn how to count one step forward and one step backwards in numbers, alright? Today, Chotu played a game at school. And right now, he is telling his mother about the same thing.
Mom, you know what? In this game, Ma'am asked us to jump a step forward and a step backwards. When she asked to jump backwards, we were supposed to jump backwards. And when she asked to jump forward, then we were supposed to jump forward, you know?
Okay, Chotu. Now, can you jump a step forward from the place you are standing right now?
Yes, Mom.
Wow, Chotu. And now jump a step backwards. Can you again jump a step backwards?
Yes, Mom.
Well done, Chotu.
Kids, did you see how Chotu jumped a step forward and then backwards? Can you tell whether this frog is jumping forward or he's jumping backwards? Yes, you are absolutely right. This frog is jumping forward. And this is called jumping backwards.
Chotu, just like you were jumping forward and backward in your class, do you know it can be done with numbers too?
How is that, Mom?
Look at these stairs that I have drawn. On these stairs, I have written numbers from 1 to 15. Will you go and stand on number 4, Chotu?
Okay, Mom.
Chotu, can you jump one step forward from the number 4 now?
Okay, Mom.
Which number did you reach now?
Mom, on jumping one step forward from number 4, I reached number 5.
You are absolutely right, Chotu. And now, jump one step forward. Chotu, so which number did you reach now?
Mom, on jumping forward from number 5, I've reached number 6.
Yes, Chotu, you are right. Now you go and stand on number 13.
Okay, Mom.
And now you jump backwards from number 13.
Chotu, which number did you reach now? On jumping backwards from number 13, I have reached number 12.
Yes, Chotu, you are right. When we go back from a number, it is counting a number lesser, or it is called backward counting. And when we move forward from a number, it is counting a number greater, or it is also called forward counting.
Hey, hi again, kids. I am back. And here you saw how we can count forward and backward from a number. You can see here a number backward from 2 is 1 and forward from 2 is 3. A number backward from 8 is 7 and a number forward from 8 is 9. So kids, that is all for today, and in this video you've learned what is moving forward or forward counting and going backwards or backward counting is, and you have also learned how to count one step forward and one step backwards. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of forward and backward counting. Till then, bye-bye, kids!
Interesting examples of forwards and backwards
counting.
Hey, hello kids, I am Parrot. In the previous video, you learned what is moving forward and going backwards, right? And how to count one step forward and also how to count one step backwards in numbers. Today in this video, we will see some very interesting examples of counting numbers forward and also backwards. Today, Chotu has gone to the park to play with his sister Pinky. When they reached there, they saw a ladder hanging from a tree and a monkey playing on it. They started watching the monkey play. Kids, we have written the numbers 1 to 10 on the ladder. Then it will be easier to see how the monkey is playing.
Look, Chotu, the monkey first jumped on the third step of the ladder and then moved a step forward, right?
So kids, can you tell on jumping from the third step of the ladder, where would have the monkey reached? Can you tell? Let's see.
And now he has reached the fourth step of the ladder. Chotu, now he has leaped his way to the ninth step. Can you see?
Pinky, see. He has taken a step back. So on which step is he now?
The step before the ninth step on the ladder is the eighth step. So it means he has reached the eighth step, right, Chotu?
So kids, did you see how the monkey is jumping forward and backward? At first, he was on the third step from which he jumped a step forward. So he reached the fourth step, right? Then he went to the ninth step and jumped a step backward. So he reached the eighth step. Today Chotu is going to his new friend Shyam's house. Come, let's see.
Shyam told me that his house number is 24. Right now I'm in front of 21.
So kids, do you know how far from here is Shyam's place? Come kids, let's see.
The number after 21 is 22. After 22 is 23. And after 23 is 24. Oh wow, there is Shyam's place.
Chotu reached Shyam's place and both of them started playing. After some time, Chotu left Shyam's house and started going to his own house. Hey kids, do you remember that when Chotu came from his own place to Shyam's house, what all house numbers did he see? That's right, he saw numbers 21, 22, 23 and then 24. Now that he is going back, he left from house number 24. The number before it is 23. The number before it is 22. And one house before that is 21. So kids, did you see that 21 is followed by numbers 22, then 23 and then 24. And then going backwards comes 23, then comes 22 and then comes 21. Hey, hi kids, and I am back. But that's it for today. Today we saw interesting examples of forwards and backwards counting. I hope you understood this topic perfectly, kids. Okay, bye for now.